Friends, humans, Star Wars fans, lend me your ears. Keep watching because this is the way to my Mandalorian Season 2 predictions. Don't click off. I have spoken. Hey guys, Melanie here, and like many of you, I am at this point completely invested in Din Djarin and his lovable, feisty, carnivorous creature, Baby Yoda. Yeah, I know, the child. Does anyone really call him that? Whatever you call him, we're all tuning in to Disney Plus on a weekly basis to see what happens on their latest spacecapades. By the way, you guys, I love Disney Plus so much that I made a song parody about it, which you can access right at... You know what? No, you can wait till the end of the video and click on the card then, okay? I have spoken. There's 5 episodes left in season 2, and there's a lot of speculation as to what's going to happen. And let's face it, tons of stuff is going to happen. But I have a pretty good feeling that Mando is headed down a path that will eventually diverge, and he is going to have to make a choice. Baby Yoda or his armor. Before I explain, let me give you my Star Wars credentials. I have enough Star Wars knowledge that most Star Wars nerds are usually a little shocked and impressed that I know things like the name of Anakin and Shmi's owner in The Phantom Menace, or the name of that goofy little creature that lives on Jabba the Hutt. It's Watto and Salacious Crumb in that order. However, these Star Wars nerds that I occasionally impress with my random brain nuggets, I have nowhere near the knowledge that they have. I have seen all of the films multiple times, and I'm currently up to date on The Mandalorian, but I've never seen The Clone Wars or Rebels, or read any novels or comics. So let me go ahead right now and give a quick sign off to the 80% of you who have now written me off as not a real Star Wars fan and who are surely about to leave this video. If you enjoyed today's video, please make sure that you click like and check out the other videos that we have on Lend Me Your Ears. And don't forget to click that subscribe button and the bell right next to it so you don't miss out on any of the Disney fun here at Lend Me Your Ears. Until next time, this is Melanie saying stay magical, my friends. And for the few loyal viewers I have who are sticking with this video, hi, Mom and Dad. Let's delve into why I think the series is building up to Mando making this ultimate choice. First and foremost, ever since he took Baby Yoda back from the client, he's been walking around in Beskar armor that he kinda shouldn't have. He was paid for bringing in the bounty and then stole the bounty back. So simply by him wearing it around, it's almost like this scarlet letter. It's a constant reminder that he broke his code and kept payment for a job that ultimately he did not follow through on. Of course, he did the right thing by saving Baby Yoda, but was keeping the Beskar the right thing? Questionable. I know that the Mandalorians believe that they are the rightful owners of all Beskar after it was taken from them in the Great Purge, but it kind of begs the question, which is more important, Mando, your armor or this child? You can't have your Bantha milk and drink it too. Well, I mean, especially if you're not gonna take that helmet off. Then season 2, and every single episode in this season so far is emphasizing the value and importance of this Beskar. Chapter 9 kicks things off with Gore Koresh trying to kill Din Djarin and make off with his armor. Then, at the start of chapter 10, we see the Jawa bounty hunter. Well, was that a Jawa? I'm really not sure. I think it was a Jawa, but, well, shoot. Now I've ruined all my Star Wars cred. I guess I'll do my sign off again. But really, all joking aside, he was all like, I'm taking Baby Yoda by knife point. Got it? And Mando was like, no, don't hurt the child. There's value in this wreckage. And the guy's like, psh, wreckage, whatever. I want your Beskar jetpack. And Mando's like, cool. And the guy's like, So obviously that possible Jawa knew that he had a hefty prize awaiting him if he turned in Baby Yoda for that bounty, but thought the Beskar jetpack would be more valuable even than that. Then lastly, in chapter 11, which sadly was not called bankruptcy, get it? Chapter 11, because that's what you file for when you file for what? Do the sign off again. Yeah, okay. In chapter 11, the heiress, we see yet again how desirable that Beskar armor is when those guys who look like Davy Jones and Pirates of the Caribbean, JK, I know they're called Quarren, because I just looked it up. When the Quarren try to trap Mando to steal his Beskar, they say, ha, we're rich, brothers. I guess Mando's armor is worth enough to make an entire ship's crew rich, which is really saying something. So, to finish up my first point, why would they continually be hammering in this notion of how valuable this Beskar armor is unless at some point Mando is faced with the decision of just how valuable it is to him? And outside of its monetary value, it's clearly also very valuable to him because it's literally life-saving. This is another thing they've shown us when he stepped out in Chapter 11 to take on all of that oncoming stormtrooper fire, and also when he was able to escape with his life from the crate dragon in Chapter 9 regardless of the acidity of its bile.
Ugh.
And again, we know too that Mando feels like getting that Beskar back from the Empire after they'd taken it in the Great Purge is a huge victory for his people. So this Beskar armor is super valuable too. Mando, his safety, and to his Mandalorian way. But now, even that way is being brought into question. For sure, Din Djarin is probably grappling with some doubts. He has just been told by Bo-Katan that he is a part of a sect of extremist zealots. And here are these other Mandalorians who just take their helmets off like it no big thing. So I think Mando is going to be coming to terms with what really makes a Mandalorian a Mandalorian. And that maybe it doesn't have as much to do with the armor, the Beskar, and the helmet as it does have to do with honor and nobility. Enter Boba Fett! Which, by the way, guys, I literally screamed, "It's Boba Fett! It's Boba Fett!" at the end of Chapter 9. The Hubs can vouch, right, Hubs?
Yep.
Here's where I think we're possibly going to be seeing a contrast. My prediction is that Boba Fett is going to stop at nothing to get his armor back, and that somehow Din Djarin is going to see that the armor doesn't make the Mandalorian, it's the Mandalorian that makes the armor. Meaning, just because someone wears the Beskar doesn't make them a Mandalorian, and just because someone doesn't wear the armor doesn't mean they're not Mandalorian. Ultimately, I think Mando is going to have to come to this conclusion, and when faced with the choice of saving the child's life or saving his armor or taking off his helmet, he's gonna do the right thing and save Baby Yoda. But what do you guys think? Am I way off here? I'm feeling so vulnerable, you guys. I'm really putting myself out there with this theory, so give me your thoughts in the comments below. And you've already heard my outro, so I'll spare you, but here's the card to click for that Disney Plus song parody that I teased you with earlier and my review of Rise of Skywalker if you're interested in more Star Wars content. Until next time, this is Melanie saying, may the Force be with you.